Where do I even begin? Today's video was filmed in March, way before the pandemic began, so be sure to wear a mask and practice social distancing when possible, especially when you're taking photos. Be safe, you guys, and let's jump into today's video. It's Allie. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here with my friend Kelly from A Side of Sweet. So one of the biggest questions that I got from you guys is how to elevate an everyday Instagram photo. So we came up with a list of different props, little trinkets that we found around Kelly's house that will definitely make a photo look so much better, and they're so simple. We have a bunch of different pose ideas, tips and tricks.
So if you want more photo tips from us, make sure you give this video a thumbs up. And hit that subscribe button, press the notification bell so we can keep in touch.
And let's get started. So we have some peonies here and they look so gorgeous. I bet you can't even tell that these are fake, but Kelly has a really awesome tip for how to make this look even better.
I actually have this secret flower sleeve, I guess you call it, that I like use over and over again, and it's pretty wrinkly and like kind of torn up in person, but you can't tell that in photos. I think that the stems on fake flowers are the kind of least realistic thing about them, so I just cover them up. I kind of crook it under my arm so you can't see the end of the stems, but you can see the paper.
Where did you get all these flowers?
I have varying levels of kind of expensive level. So these were actually really pricey. I got these at a Silk Flower Market in New York City. And just to give you kind of a range, so one of these stems was about $16. You know, that's why these look so nice and real. Now for most photos, I don't think you need that. I just use these for close-ups sometimes with for props with for food photography, so I wanted them to look really nice. But then this bouquet here was about $10 for the whole thing, and I got these from Shein. They're actually one of my favorite sources for cheap fake flowers. So these are from Shein, these are from Shein. So they're like, they're like $3 a stem. So this is like a much more budget-friendly option. And if you're taking photos from far away, you know, and you, plus if you wrap them in the paper, you know, you really can't tell that they're fake. So I don't think you really need to invest in this unless you're doing some kind of like professional styling, so.
So you guys know I love flowers, but I'm curious to know why, Kelly, you have so many fake flowers.
I have a few kind of rationales for this. One is that flowers die the moment you pick them up. You know, they don't last more than a couple days. And so, you know, these I'll use for years and years and years, and they'll always look perfectly fresh, perfectly beautiful. Over time, you know, I think it'll save me money in the long run. Every time I buy a bouquet, it's like $15 minimum.
Yeah.
And with this, I can stack them all together and get like a really giant show-stopping bouquet that's just, you know, gonna be more than what I can afford in real life with my limited prop budget. Anytime I'm like, oh, you know what, I have that project I need to shoot today, I don't have to run to the store,
that's true,
get flowers delivered, you know, stuff like that, I'm just
time
ready
saving
to go.
All right, Kelly, show me some of your go-to floral poses.
All right, so one of my favorites, basically the one that I do over and over again because you can't go wrong, is kind of tucking it under your arm. So that hides the stems, you know, that look a little faker, like I said. And then, you know, it's just something to occupy your hands. And then really the flowers, you know, you can see the whole thing. Something else, you know, is just, especially if I'm doing a seated pose, is just kind of having them to the side. You know, so then you're doing something else, whether it's like pretending to read a book or, you know, interacting with your friends, then the flowers are just there to add a pop of color. Depending if you want to do a facing away shot, you can, you know, kind of do the same thing.
Oh, I like that one.
From the back, or even...
maybe not with the sleeve, right?
Yeah, like kind of, you know, hold them in your arm like this, so not tucked under your arm, but just kind of over. So then you have this, you know, especially if you have your hair done and then you've got the nice hair shot with the flowers kind of sticking out like that.
Another go-to pose for me is when I'm sitting down, I like to kind of pull the bouquet over my head. It's fun, like, yay! Especially when you're doing portrait shots, you can push the flowers closer to the camera and then it's slightly blurred and then have the focus on your face again. So next up, I wanted to talk about hair accessories because that's a really great way to dress up any plain looking outfits. You look like a magician.
I know, right? Oh, I pulled this out of my sleeve.
Right? First, I like to lay down my scarf and then fold it into a triangle. And then I'll fold the triangle towards the center and then fold two more times. That way I get a nice thin strip that I can wrap around my hair, on baskets, or even as a bracelet around my wrist. So I'm going to show Kelly how I like to tie my little scarves around my neck. So I usually
I'm a little apprehensive here.
Oh, no, I'm just kidding. Just like I don't trust you.
Yeah, I'm about to get this tied around my neck. What could go wrong?
So whenever I tie a scarf around my neck, I always try to hide the tag because a lot of scarves always have a little tag popping out. So just try to tuck that in. And I don't really like having it centered. I like bringing it maybe like 45 degrees off to the side.
Got the vintage vibes. Number three. So I love vintage cameras. I think, as you will see here, I have a whole shelf dedicated to them. And so I just love incorporating them into photos for that kind of whimsical, kind of vintage feel.
Where did you find all of these cameras?
You know, it's kind of a work in progress. Every time I travel, I try to visit antique shops or flea markets because they are a great place to get these and often for not that expensive. So, you know, maybe like $10 is like a deal,
wow.
But you know, $15 to $30 I'd say is like kind of depending on how special and unique the camera is. You know, so this one is just like so cute and so whimsical, and it actually has a case up there somewhere too. I just love the details and the kind of whimsy that this really beautiful camera adds to photos.
I just wonder with cameras like this, how many places it's been, how many stories it was able to tell.
Totally.
It's just so magical. Like, I love my camera so much. I feel like I take it everywhere with me.
Yeah.
So showcasing a vintage camera just feels so much more special.
This one I really love. So it's got this beautiful kind of decorative leather strap. And so this I like to just slip on like this. And then you kind of have this thing that you can hold. I find it sometimes awkward and I don't like the photos where you're like covering your face. So then with the strap you kind of have, you know, this thing that you can kind of hold out to the side or, you know, put next to you.
I guess if it doesn't come with the strap, you can add your own.
Mm-hmm, definitely. All right, so this is also a favorite. I mean, it's like having a favorite child. I love them all, but it has this pop out. Isn't that amazing?
That's
so this is good
cool.
for video too, because it's got that little kind of bit of movement, and then it has this little hand strap.
Looking at all of these vintage cameras, and I'm just curious to know, like, where are some of your favorite thrift stores to find something like this?
Well, I would say in the Bay Area, it's a little tough because everything's always more expensive in a big city. I think there are a few flea markets in the area. There's one in San Francisco that's the Alamany Flea Market. And then in the East Bay, there's the Alameda Flea Market. So those are all both good places. I think most stores, they're just double the price of other places, and so I kind of avoid those. But if you're ever traveling to small towns, that is where the magic happens. So I, you know, rural like antique stores in Montana, when I go home to Wisconsin, I'm always like picking in the little, because you know, everything's about half the price of what it is in the Bay Area. So this is one time where actually being in a small town in the middle of nowhere you know, works to your advantage, unlike, you know, what people think, like, oh, you need to be somewhere really beautiful and photogenic to like get great photos.
So now I wanted to show you guys some of my favorite poses with a camera prop. So I know one of the biggest struggles for both of us is if you're holding it up towards your face as if you're taking an actual picture, you're covering your face and you don't want to do that. So what are some of your other go-to poses?
You know, I just once again use it as a way to occupy my hands. You know, so I'll kind of hold it casually on the side, or, you know, hold it next to me, kind of hold it like you can kind of laugh with it in front of you, like you're about to take a photo, but then not actually, like you said, cover your face.
Sometimes I feel super awkward, you know, posing with a friend and not knowing what to do with myself, but yeah, having a camera is a great way to interact with someone else.
True. Yeah, it adds a little bit of interest, so you know, you can kind of do those like cheesy, like, off me?
Yeah, you. Let me take your picture. Can I? The fourth prop is having a map. So this is a vintage map that Kelly picked up from an antique store.
Yes. Another one of my favorite antique finds. This, I just, you know, I knew I had to have it as soon as I saw it. So this is an atlas of the United States from, I don't even know how long ago. But, you know, you don't have to do something kind of fancy and vintage like this. Maps are super cheap, just a few dollars to just buy, you know, like a regular one that folds up and then you can kind of open it up. But, you know, I'm a lover of vintage things, and so I fell in love with this one. Yeah.
So tell me about some of the photo ideas that you had.
So, you know, vintage maps make great flat lay backgrounds. So you can lay, you know, a vintage camera over it or a set of binoculars, you know, something to kind of create that travel mood. And then another way I really like it is if you're kind of in the middle of nowhere, like that, you know, girl sitting in the middle of the highway with the mountains in the background, and then you have the map kind of open in front of you, especially if it's big like this and you can really see it. Mm-hmm. I think map shots, at least in my opinion, are better seated.
True.
You know, than kind of like standing up. You know, it's a little awkward.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like more something that can kind of lay to the side, mm-hmm. or yeah, be a photography background.
I've definitely seen the shot that you're talking about where you're just holding the map in front of you. Like, okay, we've seen that one, and pointing to the map. Speaking of cheap maps, so I have this one of Oahu. So mm-hmm. you guys know my sister moved to Hawaii a few years ago. So I wanted to grab a map just for a prop.
And I love that this one has the $5 price tag, which like proves my point. You know,
it's
that you don't
so
have to
horrible.
Spend a lot of money. And look at how bright the colors are. I love that, it's beautiful.
Hey Kelly, can you help me with this photo idea? I really need a prop, what do you think?
I have the perfect prop. Number 5, teacups.
I love your teacup collection.
I do
the best.
It's quite extensive.
Where did you find these teacups?
Once again, vintage stores, flea markets, especially for photos. You know, they don't necessarily have to be perfect, so I find if they have a little chip in them, most people will pass them over, but then, you know, you can get a good deal, like a dollar. This teacup that you have here was a dollar. As you can see, it's actually leaking a little bit. So this one, I may have gotten too ambitious with the deal, but it's still, you know.
I love that you're able to reuse something that other people would probably have just thrown away.
Yeah.
So it has a new purpose as a prop.
Cheers.
Cheers. This is a trigger warning for people who love teacups. If you have a little bit of a love for teacups, don't watch this next clip because Kelly's gonna make you wanna buy some more.
I have a problem. All right, welcome to my collection. So, as you can see, I have collected quite the, assortment of teacups. I think I've been at this though for about 10 years.
Wow.
So these are from everywhere from Goodwill, a fancy porcelain shop in Portugal, and all of them I feel like tell a story and make me think of something like where I was when I bought it.
Does this come in a set?
Actually, I brought this home in a carry-on suitcase from Portland.
Wow.
So the whole thing, it's 105 pieces, and the suitcase was so heavy I couldn't lift it, so mm-hmm. I actually had to get a stranger to help me board the plane. This is back in a safer time when people would just pick up your suitcase. Yes. And he actually carried it on the plane for me.
Wow.
And put it in the overhead bin because it was so heavy. So this teacup right here, which is also a really expensive brand and would be really expensive mm-hmm. if it was in perfect condition, but because it has a crack here, I got it for $1.
Wow.
And this is also hand painted. It's super delicate. It's got that thin wall.
Next up, let's talk about hats. So hats are probably one of my absolute favorite accessories because, again, it keeps your hands busy and adds the perfect, you know, stylized look to any outfit. I know, maybe not with the pearls though. It's a nice summery vibe to any look, and I had Kelly bring out some of her favorite hats mm-hmm. just to give you guys a quick overview of the different types of hats you can wear because they don't all look the same. I love this orange hat because mm-hmm. it gives a pop of color. I definitely imagine myself wearing this during the fall season, mm-hmm. just totally. With the leaves changing, like Kelly mentioned in Yosemite, just a beautiful hat. There's this wool fedora.
Mm-hmm. I love this, and I also have it in brown, actually. These are both pretty similar styles, but these are great for outdoor shots, I think, like a little bit more like in nature, Yosemite, you know, like great views if you're out in the forest or if you're camping or something like that. These, I think, are great
since we're moving into spring and summer, why not pick up a straw hat? Mm-hmm. I think this is a fun little like tropical accessory.
The Panama Jack, classic for tropical getaways.
You guys know I love berets in any sort of color. I know they're kind of going out of style a little bit, but I still love the pop of color. And a lot of you have asked me like, how do I like to wear a beret? And you know, you can just pop it on your head like this, or you can wear a little bit more slouched. Mm-hmm. If you don't want your bangs to show, you can just bring it closer to the front.
So I wear these by putting it low on the crown of my head, and then I kind of like flip it up. So it almost like looks like a headband from the back.
Oh.
And then you kind of look up and like slightly away. And that kind of gives, like, you can see the hat, but it's not totally overwhelming.
So now I wanted to show you a few of my favorite go-to poses with the hat. So I like to kind of like hold it under my arm. If you're crafty, add a ribbon to the back. That way you can just have it draped around your back like this. Another way, of course, is to just wear the hat on your head. So I don't like to wear it all the way tucked down. I also have a really giant head and it never works out. So I like to wear it kind of loose and off to the back. So Kelly's go-to pose is turned around with her hands back here, or like looking over your shoulder. Moving on to the basket purse. Oh my gosh, honestly, one of my favorite summer accessories. Just makes me think of going out on a beautiful picnic with my friends or a loved one. So this one is a great one from Mod Cloth. I love that the interior has this design.
Ooh, it's very pretty. Pop of color.
Yeah.
It's so cute. And I actually got mine on Etsy.
Oh.
This is handmade, and I got it mostly for photos, but also just because it's got enough space to actually use as a purse. And then I sometimes will stick like fake flowers kind of sticking out of here. I have some lavender that's kind of shorter.
All right, so Kelly, should we give all of these props a try and put them all together?
Challenge accepted.
So here is the final photo. We have all of the props laid out here. We have the flowers, the map, teacup.
Mm-hmm. Cheers.
This hat, scarf wrapped around the basket.
Vintage camera.
And I can't believe we did it. And now we're going to take some photos and see how they turn out. So I thought it'd be fun if we put all of the props together and set up a little picnic outside just to show you guys the final look.
Also, I like your dress.
Oh, thank you. I like your dress too. Wow, are we matching?
I like your shoes.
So unintentional. Like we didn't plan this at all. Wow, we covered so many different props and pose ideas. I hope you guys feel inspired. If you do, be sure to share your photos with us on Instagram using the hashtag #ASideOfSweet, just so we can find it. So if you want more from me or from Kelly, be sure to follow us on Instagram. My username is FashionByAllie, and you can find Kelly at #ASideOfSweet. I love you guys, and we'll see you in my next video. Bye!